Good afternoon, fight fans around the world tuning in. We are delighted to welcome you from the Seminole Hard Rock Hotel Casino for the official weigh-in ahead of Saturday night's Rock'em Sock'em explosive fight. Live at the Hard Rock, live at Seminole Hard Rock Hotel Casino in Hollywood, Florida, USA. All the action is presented to you by Mr. Eddie Hearn of Matchroom Boxing and sponsored to you by Bet Online, Lannistar, JD Sports, and all the thrills will be streaming live on DAZN, where it's always fight season. Seven great bouts, two championship attractions headed your way. Now it's time for an exciting video ahead of Saturday night's WBC Lightweight Championship.
He wants to fight them all.
I wanted to make a statement. I'm just gonna beat whoever they put in front of me.
America has a superstar on their hands.
And now Haney's got that fire in his eyes. On his one hitter, winner. And again from Haney, Santiago tries to hold on.
Yuriorkis Gamboa.
Stop that. Stop that. Stop that.
Chats and the noise, can't stop for the talking. I am chat with the boys, nice keep walking, yeah. Just too sharp with the prize, don't tell me I'm awesome, yeah.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, we start our way in our eight-round featherweight attraction. And it is presented to you by Mr. Eddie Hearn of Matchroom Boxing in association with Devin Haney Promotions, sponsored to you by Bet Online, Lannistar, and JD Sports. Again, this is our opening attraction. Introducing to you first onto the stage with a current record of 15 bouts, 11 victories, including 10 knockouts, and only 4 defeats, representando La República Dominicana. Please welcome Juan Gabriel Medina. And his adversary, the up-and-coming prospect with a perfect record, 11 bouts, 11 victories, including 6 wins by way of knockout. Now living and training out of Las Vegas, Nevada, by way of St. Louis, Missouri. Here is the undefeated Darren DC3 Cunningham III. This is our eight-round featherweight attraction as we get ready to officially weigh in our fighters. First, we get on to the scale at this time, representando La Romana, República Dominicana. Please welcome Juan Gabriel Medina to the scale. ...121.4, ladies and gentlemen, for Juan Gabriel Medina. And now, ladies and gentlemen, here is the undefeated one, representing St. Louis, Missouri, and Las Vegas, Nevada. Here is Darren DC3 Cunningham III. ...122.6 for Darren Cunningham III. And now we'll have our fighters face off and then pose for the cameras. This is an eight-round featherweight attraction, our opening attraction, live on DAZN. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, it is official. They are ready to go. This time we send it over to Todd Grisham with the interviews in just a bit. And now here is Todd Grisham with our interview.
Thank you, Jeremiah. Darren, hope you're this elusive in the ring tomorrow night. You try to slide out of here without me interviewing you. Congratulations on making weight. What did you make of your opponent when you faced across from him there on the stage?
You know, it's, when it comes to this and what I do, any opponent, you know, they're going to get the same treatment. So, you know, I'm not worried about him or nothing that he's going to do because I prepared, you know, mentally and physically to the furthest extent, and I'll show you come tomorrow night.
Yeah, I mean, you've been working out and training and sparring with Devin Haney. It seems like you have the best preparation possible. How did he help you in this training camp, and how did you help him as he prepares to defend his WBC title?
You know, it goes both ways. We help one another, you know. One hand don't help without the other. You know, not only with training, but just dieting and just keeping our mental right, you know. We going all the way.
All right, yeah, you're not shy. Let's hear your prediction. What happens Saturday night once that bell rings?
Saturday night, hey, they said it was 8 rounds. You know, I was unaware of this. You know, I'm ready to go 10 or even 15 like they do back in the day, but he won't make it out the 4th round.
There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Darren Cunningham predicting a 4th round KO or before that. Jeremiah, back over to you.
Thank you, Todd. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are set to wait our next attraction. This is 6 rounds in the super lightweight division. Introducing to you first, set to jump on the stage at this time, this in-ring veteran will enter the contest with a current record of 37 bouts, 28 victories, including 9 wins by way of knockout and 9 defeats. Representando la Ciudad de México, México, here is Juan José Piquet Martinez. And his opponent will enter the bout flawless, 6 bouts, 6 victories, including 5 wins by way of knockout. Here is the 2015 Pan Am Games gold medalist and the 2016 Rio Olympian for Team Canada from the Great North, Toronto, Ontario, Canada, Artur the Chechen Wolf Bjarsonov. Again, ladies and gentlemen, this is a 6-round super lightweight affair. Live on DAZN and presented to you by Mr. Eddie Hearn of Matchroom Boxing. First on the scale at this time, representing Mexico City, Juan José Piquet Martinez. .141, ladies and gentlemen, for Juan José Martinez, representing Mexico City. And now, ladies and gentlemen, his opponent, the undefeated one, representing Toronto, Ontario, Canada, Artur the Chechen Wolf, Bjarsonov. .141 on the dot, ladies and gentlemen, for the Chechen Wolf. Jose Piquet Martinez, Artur the Chechen Wolf Biarsonov, representing Canada. It's going to be a slugfest, a six-round super lightweight attraction. There you have it, ladies and gentlemen, ready to rock and roll tomorrow night. And now it's time to send it over to the one and only Todd Grisham with our interviews.
Thank you, Jeremiah. Here he is, the Chechen Wolf in the flesh. With a nickname like that, you got to be going for the kill tomorrow night. Are you going to predict a knockout for us?
Like I said before, we don't look for a knockout, but if it will present itself, I'll definitely go for it.
How much research did you do on your opponent? What do you know about him?
Me and my coach did some research, of course. He has a lot of experience, a lot of fights, so we're able to find some stuff on him. And we had a great camp, so we're ready.
Yeah, how did COVID interrupt your normal training capacity, and how did you get ready for this fight in these trying times?
It was difficult, I believe, for everyone, for sparring and, you know, for training-wise. Some gyms were closed, so, but, I mean, we're professionals, you know, so we found a way to train and to be ready and had a great camp.
I know you have a lot of fans around the world, including in your home country. What's your message to them as they're watching right now?
Hey, I want to say thank you to everyone around the world, Canada, you know, Russia, everyone that's watching me. Thank you for supporting me, and I hope to put on a great show. Спасибо всем.
There you have it, ladies and gentlemen, the Chechen Wolf. Jeremiah, back over to you.
Thank you, Todd. It's time to resume our weigh-in as we get ready for the action tomorrow night. Up next, a six-round featherweight attraction. First to take the center stage, this Mexican warrior will enter through the ropes with a record of 28 bouts, 18 victories, 14 wins by way of knockout with 10 defeats. He's the former WBF Super Bantamweight Champion out of Clovis, New Mexico, USA. Y representando Chihuahua, Mexico, here is Rafael Guerrito Reyes. And his opponent steps right back into the ring just after a huge victory 2 months ago in Tulsa, Oklahoma. He is set to enter the contest unblemished. Six bouts, six victories, including two wins by way of knockout. Here is the 2018 United States National Champion and Golden Glove Champion hailing from the Garden State, Camden, New Jersey, USA. Here is Raymond Savage Ford. And now, ladies and gentlemen, first onto the scale, representando Chihuahua, Mexico, here is Rafael Guerrito Reyes. One twenty-three for Guerrito. And now the Savage One steps onto the scale. One twenty-five point eight for Raymond Savage Four to make it official. Again, ladies and gentlemen, this is a six-round featherweight attraction live on DAZN. The big battle tomorrow night, it is official as we get our fighters to go ahead and pose for the cameras. There you have it, ladies and gentlemen, our six-round featherweight affair ready to go. It is Rafael Guerrito Reyes and Raymond Savage Ford tomorrow night. And now time to send it over to Todd Grisham with our interview with Raymond Savage Ford.
Yes, he is savage, classy, boozy, ratchet. Ray Ford, ladies and gentlemen, I got a quick question for you. There's been talk of who has the faster hands. Devin Haney, Ryan Garcia, I might throw you in the mix. Are your hands as fast as Devin Haney?
Faster than all of them.
Really? Does he know that?
Who?
Devin.
Oh, he don't got to know. I mean, but I am faster than all of them, though. They would say the same, though. They good fighters. They all good fighters, but I'm faster than them.
So what do we expect to see from you Saturday? I know how bad you wanted the knockout in your last fight. You got your opponent down but couldn't finish him. What do you want to do tomorrow night?
Just being explosive. That's how I'm coming into this fight. I'm going to be real explosive, real sharp, smart, throwing a lot of fast and hard shots, good body shots, and I'm definitely looking forward to getting him out of there.
You're what, 6-0 right now? How would you say your professional career has gone so far as you've moved from amateur to pro?
It's been going smoothly. I'm just still transitioning and, you know, getting better every day. So come tomorrow, I feel like this will be my best performance. So make sure y'all tune in.
All right, there he is, ladies and gentlemen. Ray Savage Ford, back to Jeremiah.
Thank you, Todd. And now we resume our weigh-in. Our next attraction, 6 rounds in the welterweight division. First to weigh in and fighting out of the red corner, he enters the ring. 24 bouts, 17 victories, including 13 of those wins by way of knockout, 5 defeats and 2 draws. Fighting out of West Palm Beach, Florida by way of Nicaragua, here is Marcos Bombadero Mojica. And his opponent steps into the ring unblemished with an outstanding record. 7 bouts, 7 victories, including 5 wins by way of knockout. Here's the 2018 National Golden Glove Champion fighting out of Staten Island, New York. Here is the undefeated Rashad, the Albanian Bear, Mati. And now first on the scale from Nicaragua, here is Marcos Bombadero Mojica. .146, ladies and gentlemen, for Bombadero Mojica. And the Albanian Bear is set to jump on the scale. Here he is, Rashad Mati. .146 on the nose, ladies and gentlemen, .146 for the Albanian Bear. This is our 6-round welterweight attraction tomorrow night. We are ready to rock and roll. First, with a face-off between the two. There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. They are set to go and are official. Marcos Bombadero Mojica and Rashad, the Albanian Bear, Mati. Time to send it over with Todd with our interview with the Albanian Bear.
Here he is, Rashad Mati, the Albanian Bear. Now, Habib Nurmagomedov wrestled bears when he was a kid. How did you get your nickname?
Ever since I was a kid, man, I was, you know, a little bit hairy, but I just kept going.
What did you say, a little bit hairy?
A little bit hairy.
You were hairy as a kid.
My arms and all that stuff. So, yeah, just constantly fighting, super aggressive, and just, you know, trying to, you know, obviously destroy my opponents.
Is that what we're going to see Saturday night?
That's the main goal. My main plan is to, you know, break him down each round, round by round, and if he cracks, he cracks.
Yeah, I talked to you about this yesterday during our press conference, but you want to stay as busy as possible. You said you wanted to fight every month in 2020. That hasn't been the case because of the pandemic. But what do you see your future after this fight going forward?
Same thing. Just want to stay super consistent, and fight more and more often, and then I want to fight the big names.
And I know you've got a very passionate fan base, many of them European or specifically Albanian. What's your message to them right now?
Stay tuned. Tomorrow we're going to go to war.
Kuchezi, everybody. He is the Albanian bear, Rishat Mahdi. Jeremiah?
Thank you, Todd. It's time to bring up the big men onto the stage at this time. Introducing to you first, this two-time challenger will enter through the ropes for the 23rd time, holding a record of 22 victories, including 9 wins by way of knockout and 6 defeats. Hailing from Sylvania, Ohio, here is Devin Vargas. And his opponent to the stage, a colossal juggernaut who will defend his undefeated record consisting of 21 bouts, 21 victories, including 16 wins by way of knockout. He currently holds the WBO Oriental heavyweight strap, fighting out of Las Vegas, Nevada by way of Zoco, China. Here is the Big Bang, Zhang Zhele. And now, ladies and gentlemen, first onto the scale at this time, from Sylvania, Ohio, Devin Vargas. .233, ladies and gentlemen, for our heavyweight, Devin Vargas. And now the big man, the Big Bang, Zhang Zhele, onto the scale. .259.6 for the Big Bang. Our heavyweight ready to go. .259.6. And now for the face-off, ladies and gentlemen. Two Titans going head-to-head tomorrow night. This is a 10-round attraction heavyweight division live on DAZN and presented to you by Mr. Eddie Hearn of Matchroom Boxing. Sponsored to you by Bet Online, Lannistar, and JD Sports. Time to send it over to Todd Grisham with the Big Bang, straight from China.
Thank you, Jeremiah. This is not the Big Bang. This is his translator, but he will be here shortly. It's hard to tell him apart. There he is. That's you. He's the Big Bang. All right. You're 6'6", 259.6 pounds. He told me you don't want to be 260. Why is that?
不想要250几箱,259。为什么想要在250这个阶段?因为这是我体重控制在我的状态最好的一个体重,然后所以说我把它控制在260以下,255到265之间。
I stay disciplined as much as possible. I stay below 260.
So the Big Bang, I have a feeling it's just because you're so massive, but where did that nickname come from?
介绍一下你 Big Bang的这个绰号从哪儿来的?
就是大爆炸,然后因为全世界不知道中国在职业拳击中间有重量级,所以说我想通过我就是 用我的实力来告诉世界全民
It's a big splash. It's a big bomb. And it's nobody from China that can do the damage. I want to let everybody know through my nickname, the Big Bang is coming. The bomb is coming.
Yes, you have a fight on Saturday, but you've made no secret that you want a one-day challenge for the World Heavyweight Championship. Specifically, you want Anthony Joshua. Is getting a win Saturday night enough, or do you have to knock him out and look spectacular?
周六比赛，但是大家都知道你想要对阵约书亚。你对周六比赛有什么期望？必须要击倒他才能挑战约书亚，还是你有什么想法？周六的比赛给大家留一个悬念，你们感觉怎么样？然后那就我们等到周六电视上你们能看到。
I'm not going to say anything as of right now. Keep it as a secret. You will see on TV. You see what I can do.
How do you translate the Big Bang into Chinese? How do you say that?
大爆炸。大爆炸!
Yes.
There he is, ladies and gentlemen. Back over to you, Jeremiah.
Fantastic job, Todd. And now it's time to make it official, our co-main title attraction. And it is presented to you by Mr. Eddie Hearn of Matchroom Boxing in association with Sauerland Promotions. Sponsored to you by Bet Online, Lannistar, and JD Sports. This is 10 rounds for the vacant IBF International Heavyweight Championship. And now, fight fans, here we go. First onto the stage Saturday night. He will face another great opportunity, but a tough feat ahead. One heck of a fighter entering the ropes with a record, an outstanding record, 29 bouts, 26 victories, including 13 wins by way of knockout, and only two defeats. Introducing to you the former WBC Youth World Cruiserweight Champion from Detroit, Michigan, Rock City, Rydell Booker. And his opponent ready to release his inner beast Saturday night. He walks through the ropes, perfect 10 bouts, 10 victories in addition to his win column, 8 knockouts. Introducing to you the fighting pride of Zagreb, Croatia, the current WBC International Heavyweight Champion and Olympic bronze medalist in 2016. Here is Philippe El Animal Ergovic. To the scale first, Rydell Booker. 248, ladies and gentlemen, for our heavyweight, Rydell Booker. 248, Rydell Booker from Detroit, Michigan. And now on the scale, the big man, El Animal Ergovic. 242.6 for the big man, El Animal Philippe Ergovic. There they are, the big men. This is our co-main attraction for the vacant IBF International Heavyweight Championship. 10 rounds of action for our title attraction. All the action tomorrow night live on DAZN, where it's always fight season. And now we'll send it over to Todd at this time with Rydell Booker.
You know, boxing has so many great redemption stories. You're looking at what I'm right here, Rydell. You fought James Toney. Your career was going well, but then you went to jail for over a decade. What did that teach you? What did you learn? And where are you at today in your life?
Well, you know, just having a chance to fight James Toney when I was out on a bond, when I went to prison, it taught me just more of the craftiness, you know, coming back from the old school style of boxing, being in a basement, crunk, gym, legendary, you know, learning a lot of things. So taught me how to keep my pose because I just went in like I'm the younger guy. I can beat this older guy, but he schooled me.
Well, I mean, what did you learn being in prison for 10 years? A lot of people thought you'd never fight again. You've been gone too long, and yet here you are co-main eventing a big card.
Yeah, you know, just being in prison, it taught me how to have more self-discipline and be humble about stuff. You know, it was before going to prison. Took a lot of stuff for granted, pretty much going to the top, you know, where I believe. So I was doing a lot of stuff that I didn't have business doing.
Well, it's great to see you've turned your life around, and now you get El Animal, one of your former sparring partners. He's told us it's not a matter of if he's going to win. It's how is he going to do it? How soon will he knock you out? You've never been stopped. That's pretty disrespectful to me. What's your thoughts on his prediction?
I mean, you know, some people got to say what they got to say to either hype themselves up or anything like that, but this is a business, it's a sport, so whatever you got to do to give yourself the drive, the motivation, but I know who I am, he know who stands in front of him, so it's be a more challenge for him to try to knock me out than me getting a victory.
All right, right up. Thank you for the time and good luck to you. And now we will welcome in El Animal himself, the undefeated fighter out of Croatia, Philip. Congratulations on your successful career so far. How you feeling right now as you get set to take on Rydell Booker?
I'm feeling very well. I want to say thanks to my coach, Pedro Diaz, for preparing me very well. And thanks to organizations, to Matchroom, to Eddie Hearn, to Team Sauerland, to my manager, Željko. And I'm feeling very good and I'm happy to be here.
I know you love to knock guys out. What are we going to see from you tomorrow night?
You're going to see great performance. First, before knockout, I need to outbox him. I will not just knock out him. I will outbox him first, and I will show my boxing ability. And he's a slick fighter. He's a good fighter. He knows to box, and I need to be on the top level.
I know you've wanted a world title shot. You think you're good enough to fight the best of the best. What's your dream matchup? Which guy would you like to fight if you could call your own shot after this bout on Saturday?
I want to come on the top, of course. I want to become champion. And what way we're going to go, no one knows. It's on my manager, on my promoter, to match me up with the best in the division. And I feel ready for everyone.
Filip Hrgović, good luck to you.
Thank you, man.
All right, Jeremiah, back to you.
Thank you, Todd. And now, fight fans, the moment has arrived. We make it official on the scale. The now, the future of boxing will continue his dream for greatness, looking to prove a huge statement as the current world champion as he faces, considered to be a very tough opponent, a seasoned veteran who fought the best and owner of multiple championships. 12 rounds for the WBC Lightweight Championship of the World. It is presented to you by Mr. Eddie Hearn of Matchroom Boxing in association with Devin Haney Promotions and TGB Promotions. Sponsored to you by Bet Online, Lannistar, and JD Sports. Streamed live on the Zone. Now it's time to rock and roll and bring up the challenger at this time. A seasoned veteran, a multi-time champion holding an impressive record, 33 bouts, 30 victories, including 18 wins by way of knockout and only 3 defeats. He's a proud Cubano living and training out of Miami, Florida, USA. Here's the former unified featherweight champion of the world, El Ciclón de Guantánamo. Here is Yuriorkis Gamboa. Yuriorkis Gamboa! And now, ladies and gentlemen, his opponent will step into the ring. A much-anticipated battle, perfect 24 bouts, 24 victories, including 15 wins by way of knockout. The reality of boxing, the future of boxing, now living and fighting out of Las Vegas, Nevada, the multi-time champion, the reigning, defending, undefeated WBC lightweight champion of the world. Here is Devin the Dream Haney. First onto the scale at this time, the challenger, Yuriorkis Gamboa. 135 on the dot, ladies and gentlemen, es el clon de Guantánamo, Yuriorkis Gamboa. And now, ladies and gentlemen, here he is, the WBC lightweight champion of the world, Devin the Dream Haney. .135, ladies and gentlemen, for the WBC lightweight champion of the world, Devin the Dream Haney. All the action presented to you by Mr. Eddie Hearn of Matchroom Boxing. Ladies and gentlemen, the correct weight, Devin Haney, 135 on the nose for the Dream. As they face off, this is our main attraction, WBC Lightweight Championship of the World, tomorrow night, live on DAZN. There you have it, ladies and gentlemen, it is official. It's time to get into DAZN. Gamboa, Haney tomorrow night, live on DAZN, and presented to you by Matchroom Boxing, Eddie Hearn's Matchroom Boxing, ready to go. And now at this time, we send it over to Todd Grisham with Yuriorkis Gamboa.
Former two-time world champion Yuriorkis Gamboa, congratulations on making weight. I know it's never easy at this stage of your career. Obviously, you've read all the articles, you've seen the video, a lot of hype surrounding Devin Haney. Do you think he's as good as everyone says he is?
Dice que hay mucha gente hablando mucho de la pelea esta, que tuve mucha gente hablando muchas cosas, que Haney es la gran cosa, el próximo gran campeón. ¿Qué tú crees de todo lo que esa gente están hablando?
No, lo que la gente hablan, como te digo, son cosas personales de ellos y cada cual tiene su opinión.
Dice, each person can have their own opinion, you know, it's up to them. They can say whatever they want.
This may be your last opportunity at a world title. Are you going to have to fight like a desperate man?
De campeonato. ¿Tú vas a pelear como una persona desesperada?
Ah, yo siempre he peleado como un guerrero y siempre he hecho lo mejor arriba arriba.
I've always fought the same way that I always fought, is like a warrior, and I'm gonna, and you know, I'm with calm, and I'm gonna come out victorious.
What's the key to you winning this fight on Saturday?
¿Cuál es la cosa importante, la llave de tú ganar la pelea este sábado?
Bueno, el enfoque que tengo en mi carrera deportiva y el entrenamiento que hice.
And my focus on this fight has been tremendous, and the preparing for this fight has been awesome. So that's what's gonna carry me.
Buena suerte.
Muchas gracias.
All right, there he is. He is the challenger, Yuriorkis Gamboa, squaring off for the WBC Lightweight Championship of the World against my next guest at this time, the Dream, Devin Haney. Devin, you made weight. Well done. I know it's not easy in these times under coronavirus. How did this pandemic affect your preparation?
It motivated me. It gave me time to work harder and time to, you know, fully focus on this fight, you know, and I'm ready.
I know you've felt the pressure seeing how all the other four horsemen, as we call them, with Ryan Garcia, Tank, and Lopez, how they did in their fights, and Garcia fighting in a couple weeks. How much pressure is there on you to have not just a win, but a spectacular performance?
No different than any other fight. Every fight I go in and I want to put on a great performance. It's always pressure to outdo, you know, my last performance. So I'm going in there with a lot of motivation to go in there and get the win, but not only get the win, I want to look good. So
you said you want to look good, you want to win for your fans, but you also mentioned when you first met Yuri Gamboa when you were a child that he and his coaching staff didn't really seem to believe in you or give you much respect. You say you're going to earn it tomorrow night. How do you do that?
I'm going to dominate. I want to make a statement with this victory. I don't only want to beat him. I want to beat him worse than he's ever been beat before. And I want to show him that I'm on a total different level than anyone you have been in the ring with.
All right, before we let you go, there's a special presentation now from the WBC. Andre Suleiman has something he would like to give you, Devin.
It is my great honor to represent my late grandfather, Jose Suleiman, and my uncle, Mauricio Suleiman, our proud champion, Devin Haney, his WBC lightweight championship belt. Please, Devin.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
It's always nice to get a new belt, is it not?
I always love getting belts.
We wish you great success, and please represent the WBC as a proud champion you are.
Congratulations. And I know you gave his father a belt as well.
Yes, please.
WBC has started a tradition of awarding the trainers of the champions a belt. And it's my pleasure, and in behalf of the WBC, Bill Haney, I'd like to present you with the trainer's belt. Beautiful belt.
What are your thoughts, Mr. Haney?
Amazing. It's an honor and a dream come true to have Devin on this stage and be right here representing with him.
All right. Thank you. Congratulations, guys. Thank you, WBC. One more thing from Devin.
I look forward to being a WBC champion for a lot of years. This is only the beginning.
All right, Jeremiah, back to you to close the show.
All right, Todd, thank you so much. We made it official here. And that being said, tomorrow night, live on DAZN, it is Haney and Gamboa. That being said, it's time to get into DAZN.
He wants to fight them all.
I wanted to make a statement. I'm just going to beat whoever they put in front of me.
America has a superstar on their hands.
And now Haney's got that fire in his eyes. On one, hit a winner. And again from Haney, Sadio tries to hold on.
Yuriorkis Gamboa.
Stop that. Stop that.
Yeah, I hear him chatting the noise. Can't stop for the talking.